It's Tanat Day, thanks to the wines of Uruguay. I've got three Tanat-based wines. I'm going to taste them all and try to guide you towards the right one. That's all coming up. Hello, hello, hello. Welcome back to Exotic Wine Travel. And we are tasting some exotic wines today from the grape Tanat from Uruguay in South America. The wines of Uruguay aren't as famous as the wines from Argentina or Chile, but it is the fourth largest wine producing country in South America, so the wines are to be reckoned with. One of the signature varieties there is Tanat. It's a French grape brought to Uruguay by the Basque settlers in the late 1800s. Those with classical European palates associate Tanat with the wines of Mariran. Tanat is a dark, thick-skinned grape, really tough, really rustic. To me, similar to Sagrantino a little bit in Italy. You get some blueberry flavors, some leather, but it's really tough. The tannins are really hard. The acidity can be quite generous. I have tasted some Tanats from Uruguay. They seem to be a little softer, a little more approachable. You know, those wines from Mataran, you have to cellar them for quite some time to get the tannins to soften, where Uruguay, they try to make the wines a little bit more approachable early on. I want to thank Uruguay Wine for sending these over for Tanat Day, giving me a chance to taste these. I am by no means an expert in Uruguay or South America. I'm hoping to get there soon once the world starts to clear up. If you want to learn more about South American wine, check out my friend Amanda Barnes. She has a website and an upcoming book called South America Wine Guide. I'll throw it down there. There's lots of resources of all the major wine producing countries in South America, not just Argentina, Chile, and Uruguay, by the way. Uruguay, it's a smaller country right on the Atlantic Ocean. There's about 6,300 hectares of vineyards, 180 commercial producers, has a little bit of a maritime, but a little bit of a warmer maritime climate. So think kind of Bordeaux, but a little bit warmer. So you are going to get long growing seasons, which is important for this grape to ripen up the tough tannins. I think Tanat makes up about 24% of all grapes planted in Uruguay, so it is becoming the signature grape variety. You don't see a ton available worldwide. I think the most notable ones I've seen around the world are Garzón, which are excellent wines, excellent value for money if you want to seek them out. But let's get into these. I've never tasted these three wines before, so I am excited. First up, Familia Traversa. This is the Noble Alianza. This is Cabernet Franc, Tanat, and Marsalin. Marsalin is a cross between Cabernet Sauvignon and Grenache. This is the only blend we have here today. Then we're going to taste two varietal Tanats. 2019. You know, it seems like it might be young, but you got to remember, these are Southern Hemisphere wines, so the harvest is at the beginning of the calendar year, not towards the third quarter like in the Northern Hemisphere. So hence, these wines are approximately a year older than their European counterparts. Okay, seems like an interesting blend. Cabernet Franc maybe brings some perfume, some herbaceousness, maybe Tanat brings some savoriness, and Marsalin can be fruity and spicy at the same time. But I don't know, maybe, let's see. Let's check it out here. So it does smell like a young wine, surprisingly. This does have a lot of herbaceous and grassy notes that I would associate maybe with Cabernet Franc. Some cherry type flavors, a little bit of blueberry, maybe a touch of leather. It's not super complex, but it smells quite pleasant. Nothing to be disappointed about. Nose is nice. A little bit simple, but nice. Let's give it a go. It's a young wine. There's a lot of peppery notes, a lot of spiciness. Maybe that comes from the Marsalin that I find really attractive. Medium body. It kind of tastes like a little bit of a minimal intervention wine, although I don't think that's the case, but that's what it kind of tastes like, a little bit of that rawness. I think it's quite pleasant drink. It's not super complex, not super long, but something that I would be more than happy to drink, especially with a meal. Not bad, not bad. Not the most complex red in the world, but definitely juicy, easy to drink. I think a lot of people will like it, especially if you like some of that greenness, that herbalness that you get out of Cabernet Franc, and a little bit of spiciness. Next up, we have the Jiménez Méndez 100 Años Tanat 2018. 100 Años, 100 years. I don't know, maybe it's a special type of wine because 100 year anniversary, I don't know. The alcohol levels in Tanat can start to rise quite quickly, but this is at 14%, which I'm liking the sound of. It's aged in French and American oak. Let's give it a smell. So the wood definitely comes on strong here. Lots of wood, bacon fat, vanilla type flavors. But underlying, there's a lot of blueberry fruit and blackberries. I don't know if you've ever had fresh blackberries. I used to have it when I was a kid. They grew in the forest. My grandma used to have a little blackberry bush. Oh, so good. Your fingers turn all purple. Your teeth turn all purple, but really delicious stuff. Mulberry type flavors too, I'm picking up. That's basically dark berry fruit, bacon fat, a little bit of vanilla. maybe a hint of tobacco. The wood comes out a lot, and you know what? For some reason, it's not really bothering me that much. It's working actually quite well with the wine, which is surprising because I complain about wood a lot in reds. I would never guess that this is Tannat Blind because the tannins are quite supple. They're round. They're massaging my palate. They're not gripping really hard. It's, Tannat tannins sometimes can be tough, chewy, and rustic, really make you go... Surprising, if people like wood, there is a lot of oak here, so if people like that, but yet don't want those tannins, still want a little bit of roundness, smoothness, I think this is actually a nice choice. Not my favorite wine in the world, but I'd like to see how this wine does with a couple more years in the bottle, once the wood starts to integrate a little bit better. Doesn't have the longest finish in the world, but you want to introduce yourself into Uruguay Tannat, I think this is a good place to start, to be honest. Let's move on to the Buza Tannat. Oh, there goes my flag. Let's move on to the Buza Tannat 2018. And Buza is the appropriate term here. 16% alcohol. Wow. It almost looks significantly darker, inkier in the glass. Now, this is the Tannat that I am familiar with. You can get a lot of leather, a lot of blueberry, a touch of tobacco, a touch of rusticness. It smells to me like those wines I've had from Mariran before. It's big. Dark berries. Blueberries, a little bit of tobacco, menthol, leather. Surprisingly, the heat's not coming out of glass and taking over. This is a full-bodied, powerful red wine. What I like about this, even though it's 16% alcohol, I feel it just a little bit on the throat, just a little bit, but it's not disturbing me. You get that alcohol, you get that heat, and it's a big wine, but there's a lot of savory components to it, a lot of complexities. It's not just a big fruit bomb, which I'm really appreciating. The alcohol does come in a little bit high, so you gotta be prepared. Maybe have some meat. You gotta be ready for the 16% alcohol. That's no joke. This is aged in French and American oak, but the wood integration is perfect. The grapes must be really ripe, obviously, from the 16% alcohol. This is my favorite wine out of the bunch, which is surprising because in terms of body, more medium-bodied style, I'd probably go for these other two in normal circumstances, but I can't deny the quality of the Buza. It's really, really well done. I think I've seen these wines around the world for $15 to $20. For you, if you want to go out there and try some Uruguayan Tannat, I definitely recommend the Buza. But you got to be ready for a big, full-bodied, high alcohol wine. I think the Buza would appeal to those that maybe like the French wines of Mataran. It has some of those similar qualities. The Jimenez Mendez, if you're picking it up, if it's a wine that's like $12 to $14, I'm all good with it. The Familia Traversa, I actually like in terms of just to drink. It's not super complicated, but it's really nice to drink. The Familia Traversa really does taste like a quote-unquote minimal intervention wine. That's it for Tannat Day. Celebrate, go out and find some Tannat, try something new, explore. And I'd like to know, have you ever tried any Tannat from Uruguay before? I'd love to know. Do you have any favorite producers? Leave it in the comments below. I hope to make it down there soon. Happy Tannat Day. And you know what? I'll see you soon.
Hello, thanks for watching.
Hey, you made it to the end. Make sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel, click the bell so you know when new videos are out. If you like content like this, check out our Patreon page where you get some behind the scenes exclusive content. Thanks for watching. Cheers.
Cheers.